Abarigani, Mainduga Nadada. Mainduga Nadada, I would like to pose a question to you today. May not be important to you, but it's very important to me. I need to know. What I need to know is, are you aware of what's going on? Migrant children and their separation from their mothers and fathers. Some of them dying in the bush. Do you understand what the hype is about on another level? You see, my brothers and sisters, what goes around comes around, and what comes around goes around. You see, this country was founded on immorality, on racism. Because you see, it took the separation of babies from their mothers and their fathers and send them to the new land they had taken from another people, usurped them, took the land, stole our people, separated mothers from their babies in the millions. And they did this over 4 centuries to us, and are yet doing it today via their police departments, their prisons, their medical experiments. Understand what I'm trying to get you to see. You see, they can't deal with this. They tell us to get over this. That was a long time ago. My foreparents hadn't arrived in America yet. The answer should be to them, no, they weren't here. But you are certainly reaping the benefits. Oppression of my people over 400 years and what is termed chattel slavery. So you hold responsibility with them. This is your country. You reap what you sow. You sow just citizenship right here in the United States. So you reap what the United States produces. And there's nothing wrong with standing up for human rights. But you see, they're trying to distract us from who they really are. Their non-morality infested being. Non-humanistic being. And what they have done is they have manipulated us because they cannot forgive themselves or cannot receive our forgiveness until they show remorse for us, and they know this, so they fear us. See, we got the whole card on. That's why they always talk about you need to get over it. Our people don't forget anything. Research. Gather the documents for your proof. I have the proof I need. I spent my childhood reading history books, specifically black history, slavery, Egypt, Ghana, Mali, Sangay, the modern states of European constructed geographical Africa. So my brothers and sisters, get back to the point. You see, they're playing a game because they feel shame, essentially. And they will not ask for forgiveness because they're too selfish. too arrogant, too egotistical. So what they are doing in this event, and they're not putting the event down, is they are showing some parallel things that are happening in America that happens to us today, and has been happening to us ever since 1619. All the documents I need. All I need is for you, my people, to read and to understand. Get your stuff together and realize what they are intending to do now is they're getting us to empathize, you see, to get to know and feel the people who are coming into the United States via migrations presently. The separation of the mothers from their babies. People being lost. See, it sounds like our historical journey in these lands. So we are supposed to relate to that, thereby being who we are. Being able to feel the situation out, or being able to die to the self and being reborn in the other and becoming the other. Feeling the other, knowing the other. Since they know we are this kind of people, they are trying their very best to get us to identify with, to forgive them through them correcting their actions by allowing these people to come into this land, which doesn't belong to anybody. It certainly doesn't belong to the European. It belongs to anybody who's here now. It belongs to the Africans who were brought here in slavery and worked this land. Maybe not all of it, but certainly what they call the Black Belt. We worked that for free for 300 years. It's ours. It's just a question of whether we're going to stand up and take what's ours. Ask for what's ours. Not demand what's ours. If it's not forthcoming, without a consequence, that'll make them think twice about it. Did you get my drift? So anyway, we can identify with, we can understand the situation in the area called Latin America, at the borders of the United States of America. We can understand all of that. We empathize with them. But we want to let everybody know right now, it's Africa first, it's my people first, it is about one global Black African love. We can't lose with the stuff we use. Once again, peace and hotep to you, my Nduba Nanada.